Hi, my name is Linda Leukas. Usually I work with kids, explaining them the concepts of computer science in fun and exciting ways. But this time, I'll get to know the more sinister side of technology through the hacks, intrusions, and threats we face in our everyday, private, and work lives. So often, cybersecurity sounds like sex education, full of fear-mongering or scary visions, or alternatively, dull and impractical. In this series, I'm on a mission to change the way we speak about cybersecurity, and I know exactly the place where to start. What kind of techniques might the hackers use?
Well, it starts off with the basics. They're going to try to just bait you with a trap. You know, so is an elephant a mammal?
Yes.
Is a horse a mammal?
Yes.
Okay, and is a cat a mammal?
Yes.
Is a tortoise a mammal?
No.
Okay, do tortoises walk?
Yes.
Do birds fly?
Yes.
Are penguins birds?
Yes.
Do penguins fly?
No.
It's really hard, like, you can't be perfect 100% of the time. It's just not possible. And so people across the board need to be informed and educated as to like things that they should keep in mind and traps to watch out for. Because the goal of the attacker is just to get on the network. And their ultimate goal is to find the IT admin who's got the keys to the kingdom, like the passwords.
So why is it that people don't care about cybersecurity as much as they care about, say, real world things and objects?
Tangibility. And the intangibility of information and data, I think, is one barrier. And then the securing your passwords in your database, those words don't invoke any sort of like warm, fuzzy feelings. And I think it makes it less tangible, and people don't think of it as maybe as real that they need to protect it.
The world of cybersecurity has come a long way from its innocent beginning. In the early days of hacking, viruses were mostly spread for fun by kids on floppies and academics sending each other worms. The 1990s introduced us to the early virus emails, and with the growth of local networks, internet, and email, the innocent playground showed its darker side. The early 2000s saw credit cards being hacked and ordinary people as well as companies losing millions of dollars. Nowadays, in the world of cybersecurity, no one is safe. Bank accounts can be hacked, companies jeopardized, and elections influenced. New technologies keep evolving, so security has to keep up with its growing pace. Even though the motivations and approaches of attacks have changed, the defenders are responding to the ever-changing threat landscape. Back in the days of the first viruses, it was easy to know if you had been infected. A caterpillar appeared on your screen, a walker strolled across your desktop. But nowadays, cybersecurity is a much more complex world, and you might not even know when a hacker is planning their attack. That's why we need the experts. So one of the things that really frustrates me is that all of these cybersecurity issues are so intangible, and it's hard to understand the jargon and all of these things. What if we could make viruses and attacks and threats somehow more tangible?
Should we try it out?
Yes, let's try it out. So what about things like social engineering and phishing? How would you explain those?
So one example of that social engineering is phishing. So for example, this skeletal guy is so used to receiving this flower, and then all of a sudden there's this mischievous attacker that knows that this guy continuously receives this kind of flowers at his doorstep, and one day replaces it with the same looking flower. And it could be so that this guy doesn't have an idea that it's different because he sees it every day.
He doesn't pay attention.
Mm-hmm. But if you look closely enough, actually, you will realize that there is a difference. Social engineering actually is a pretty effective type of attack. It tries to exploit the very foundation of our society, and that's called trust. And attackers know that, which makes the human factor the weakest link in the cybersecurity
So it's domain. Not about the code, it's about the human trust.
Yes. If, for example, whenever you visit your news website, it actually pulls content and formatting from a website? Do you know that it pulls ads from yet another website? And do you know that it pulls analytics from another website? So by simply visiting that website, you're actually putting implicit trust on those third-party services that's running behind the scenes. For the attackers, all they need to do is to find the most insecure element in that entire supply chain network, and then they use that compromised entity to get to their ultimate target.
People think being safe from attacks is about being careful online and not having anything to hide. Well, it turns out it's less about having something to hide, more about having something to protect. In the next episode, I'm going to have a first-hand experience of what it feels like to get hacked.